The High West, first mentioned by Ganfall in chapter 237. It's implied that the High West is another way or path that leads to Skypiea. A popular theory has always been that the High West is located in Elbaf. What if that's true? Well, in this video I want to explore that idea, and what we might see later on in this giant arc. Now of course this is all conjecture, but without further ado. Elbaf is inspired by Norse and Viking mythology, but One Piece also borrows and merges cultures across arcs. A perfect example of this is Dressrosa, an arc that has a mix of Spanish and gladiatorial elements. Oda can draw inspiration from the Wild West, adding a cowboy aesthetic while maintaining the Viking slash Norse influence. The giants of Elbaf could embrace cowboy style attire, blending Norse and Western styles, similar to Jaguar D. Saul. Perhaps Miss All Sunday adopted this style from him. But more on those two in a bit. The High West could be a remote, high-altitude area in Elbaf, where only the toughest giants survive. This region would have a lawless feel, similar to the American Wild West. High West disputes might be settled through traditional giant battles, but with a cowboy twist. Ichiro Oda's sense of humor could also incorporate comedic Western tropes like bar brawls, paralleling the scene in Mocktown, showdowns or duels with massive weapons or oversized revolvers, maybe even giant-shaped cannons. The High West could be where Usopp's sharpshooting skills shine, allowing him to face off in a cowboy-inspired duel. Who better to have a duel with than his own father? You see, his father is known as one of the most talented snipers in the world.
Eh, that's nothing. I could shoot an ant between the eyes from across town.
Usopp's ambition to surpass his father's skill could culminate in Elbaf. After all, they have both dueled a cowboy in the past. In my opinion, Elbaf is a parallel to the Jaya and Skypiea arcs. There are so many connections between all three. The Straw Hats were said to have went through the Sleeping Mist Belt before reaching Elbaf. Before reaching Jaya, in the anime, there is a filler arc that was called the Rainbow Mist Arc. Luffy is told that Upper Yard is a forbidden place that's guarded by four powerful priests. In chapter 1128, he is also warned by a mysterious man riding a grasshopper that the Sun God Temple is a forbidden place, and it's guarded by four deities. There are tons of things in Elbaf and Skypiea that just match up. Even the little things like Loki's tattoo, looking very similar to the Shandian's tattoos. I mean, I don't think it's coincidence that Enno has an attack named El Thor. And on top of that, the very first appearance of Luffy in Elbaf attire shows him wearing a helmet that's actually kind of shaped like Enno's ears, if you ask me. Here's a cool little thought. You know how there's a golden bell in Skypiea? Now what if there's a golden lyre at the top of Elbaf and Usopp has to play it? A lyre playing a golden lyre. But that's just a crazy thought. In popular media, the dynamics of cowboys and Native Americans are often depicted together. Oda used Native American and Mesoamerican aesthetics for the Shandians of Skypiea. With this in mind, perhaps Elbaf's High West will serve as a thematic counterpart to Skypiea, presenting a frontier or cowboy culture as a contrast to the Shandians' indigenous elements. I want to close this video talking about Nico Robin, and what would make her and the crew go to a place like the High West. Maybe she wants to buy another outfit like the one she wore in Alabasta, who knows? No, but seriously, Robin's journey to Elbaf would undoubtedly be motivated by her quest to uncover the world's lost history, and possibly learn more about the ancient weapon Uranus. In this pursuit, the crew could journey to the High West. Now, during their exploration, Robin might hear rumors of a lone giant with a distinct laugh. I like to end all my videos on a happy note, but I'm gonna do something a little bit different with this one. Nico Robin and Saul's reunion could foretell a dark plot in the series. You see, Nico Robin and Saul are connected by many things. The sense of freedom, the will to laugh when things seem dire, but most importantly, they are forever linked to the tragedy of O'Hara and the burning of the Tree of Knowledge. Could the Tree of Elbaf share the same fate?